Hello students, hope all of you are fine at your home. In the last video, we have discussed about the Orientalism and the Anglicist. Now, in this video, we will discuss how children were taught in the British school, British time period, before British time period or after the Britishers. So, look at the page number 101. See the heading, what happened to the local schools. In this video, we will discuss about the education system before the Britishers and after that coming the Britishers. We will discuss about the pre-British time schools and during British time schools in this video. Now, the Britishers wanted to change the education system before Britishers, Gurukul system, Pathshalas were working. But when the Britishers entered in India and they thought the changing of the schooling system, the Britishers wanted to know the Indian education system before the Britishers. So they gave responsibility to collect this information to the William Adam. See, in this paragraph we will discuss about the Indian system before Britishers and after the Britishers. So first of all, we will know about the William Adam. Who is he? He is a Scottish missionary. The company officers gave him a responsibility to know about the vernacular schools. Vernacular schools means local schools. Vernacular schools, education is given in the local language. Next is, he has to give information about this schooling system to the company. Company means British India. He toured the states of Bengal and Bihar and he collected the information about the schools. And this report is given by the William Adam, and this is known as the William Adam's report. Now, the report of the William Adam that is given by him, its features are, these features are relating to the Indian education system before the Britishers. First feature is that there were over 1 lakh Pathshalas in Bengal and Bihar. Second, these institutions started by a guru, also teacher. Third, education was flexible. It means that no fixed fees at that time, no books, no buildings were for the students, no furniture for students, no blackboards, no attendance and no examinations for the students. Next feature is, that is the fourth, classes were organized under a tree in a temple or in a corner of the village. Means there was no particular building for the students. Fifth feature is that fees depend on parents' income. Means the parents who were rich, they can pay more fees, and who are the poor, they can pay less fees. According to the income, the fees is dependent. Sixth feature is teaching was oral. Matlab, no notebooks were at that time, no books were at that time, no exams were that time. So the teaching was only in the oral. Seventh feature is all classes students sat together. Whether he is a student of the nursery class, he is a student of the first class, or he is a student of the 10th class. Next, eighth feature is Adam discovered that this flexible system was according to the need of the local people. Means, whenever the people, they are free and they have no need of their children in the working of the fields, the students can go to the school. If the parents need these children at the work, then they are not allowed to go their students to the school. Ninth feature is, when there was work in the fields, school was shut down. Means, when the parents or the students were busy in the fields, school was not open for the student. At that time, the school was closed. This is the information regarding the schools that were before the Britishers. Now, next heading is the new routines, new rules. In this paragraph, we will discuss about the new rules or new routines that were made by the Britishers. Means we will discuss the school's condition after the entering of the Britishers or after the education policy. Its first feature is up to 1850s, the company was concerned primarily with the higher education, means company main focus on the higher education. Second feature is a situation changed after 1854. Why the situation changed in 1854? Because in 1854, Woods Dispatch was established, organized. What happened in 1854? We will discuss what happened in 1854. Its main change is the Woods Dispatch. The company decided to improve the system of the vernacular schools. How the company changed the system of the vernacular school system? Its first point is how it can be possible. It is possible through the company, means Britishers. They thought that they will introduce orders, imposing routines, rules upon the students or upon the education system. Yes, how they can impose the routines, new rules, how can it be implemented? Its first point, how can it be implemented? Its first point is they appoint government pandits. Who is the government pandit? Government pandit is the in charge of looking four or five schools. Means four or five schools came under the a person who is known as the pandit. Now we will discuss about the government pandit's work. Yes, its first work is he visit paathshalas. Means he visits paathshalas. He also checked the work of the paathshalas. Second, he wanted to improve the standard of teaching. Third, gurus will submit periodic reports. Means whenever a pandit is appointed, he has to give his periodic reports to the Britishers. The period time, it depends upon the working of the guru, whether it is related to the 15 days or it is related to the 1 month report. Fourth, proper timetable, regular classes should be started. Why regular classes should be started? Before it's there was the no regular classes, school was closed at the time of the at the need of the parents. Fifth, annual examination system should be started. Before it, there was no written examination because the oral education system was in the oral. Sixth feature is the regular fees. In the pre-British time period, there was the no regular fees. So when the Britishers entered India and wanted to change the education system, first of all, its effort was the regular fees. They started to collect the income from the parents, so they make a plan to collect regular fees, regular attendance, fixed seats, and obey new rules of the discipline. So these are the features of the new education system that the Britishers wanted to implement in the India. Why what paathshalas would accept these rules? Paathshalas accept would these rules? Its main reasons are, number one, these paathshalas follow these rules, they get government grants. Means they are able to collect grants from the Britishers. If they are not following these rules, they are not able to get grants. Grant means financial aid. Financial aid from the Britishers. So due to the financial aids, all paathshalas are compelled to follow these rules. Now we will discuss the impact of the this new education system. Impact means its effect. Effect on the poor peasants. Peasants means farmers. Regular fees, attendance, need regularity. But poor peasants' families suffered a lot because they have to go with their parents for the work. Because poor parents have the lack of money, so they take their children with them for their work. And whenever the students are busy in the work, they are not able to go to the school. So due to the new regularity, or the new rules or the routines, the students have to go to school daily. So this is the effect on the poor peasants. Now, the next point is the agenda for a national education. In this paragraph, we will discuss about the views of the British officers or the views of the Indian people regarding the education system. Some Indian felt that Western education would modernize them. So they wanted that the more schools be opened by Britishers in the Indian, because they are supporting the westernized education, so they are in the favor of the Britisher or the Western education. Some Indians were against the Western education, like Mahatma Gandhi and the Rabindranath Tagore. These were the main important personalities of this education system. Let us look at why, what they had to say. According to Mahatma Gandhi, English education has enslaved us. We will discuss about this in this complete paragraph. I am telling this in the points. Mahatma Gandhi said, colonial education created a sense of inferiority in the minds of the Indians. Means Mahatma Gandhi ke accordingly kya tha ki jo colonial Britishers education de rahe hain India mein, uske karan jo Indian log hain wo apne aap ko inferior samjhenge. Matlab apne aap ko wo Britishers ke comparatively wo apne aap ko down samjhenge aur unki personality hai wo kam hogi. How this it made us see Western civilization as superior and destroyed the pride we had in our कल्चर. अकॉर्डिंग टू हिम उसके अकॉर्डिंगली क्या था कि हम वेस्टर्न एजुकेशन को सुपीरियर समझेंगे और जो कि हमारा अपना कल्चर है उसको हम इन्फीरियर समझना शुरू कर देंगे. सो उसके अकॉर्डिंगली क्या था कि जो वेस्टर्न एजुकेशन है मतलब उसके कारण इन्फीरियरी कॉम्प्लेक्स है इंडियन लोगों में आ जाएगा और इंडियन लोग अब अपने आप को मतलब ब्रिटिशर्स के कंपेरेटिवली वो डाउन समझना शुरू कर देंगे. अकॉर्डिंग टू महात्मा गांधी the features that he wanted in the English Indian education system is, its first point is, he wanted education that create a sense of self-respect in Indians. Self-respect in Indian, its first point. He wanted that the education system in India should be that create a sense of self-respect. Second feature is the, he wanted medium of instruction should be in Hindi, not in English. He preferred the Hindi language. Third, if English language is followed, that Indians would become strangers in their own land. उनके अकॉर्डिंगली क्या था कि अगर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज में उनको एजुकेशन दी जाएगी तो इंडियन लोग हैं वो अपनी ही जमीन पे अपने आप को अजनबी समझना शुरू कर देंगे. Indians would become strangers in their own lands. Fourth feature is that English education is not able to make people to communicate with other people. Fifth feature is that Western education didn't focused on the oral knowledge. Means Western education is only related with the reading and the writing. Means it doesn't focus on the oral knowledge. Sixth point is that it didn't give practical knowledge. It provide only the bookish knowledge. That is not helpful to improve the condition of the Indian people. Seventh, according to him, a person is educated when a person know how to work with own hands, learn a craft. When they have the practical knowledge, then a person is said he is a educated, otherwise he is not educated. Means if a person has not practical knowledge and that knowledge is not applicable in the daily life, so this education has no value and this is only the bookish knowledge that is not useful for the Indian people. So this all about the Mahatma Gandhi's views about the Indian education system that he wanted to implement in the Indian education system. Now we will discuss about the Tagore's Abode of Peace. In this paragraph or in these pages, we will discuss about the Tagore's views about the education. First of all, I will tell you about the Rabindranath Tagore's life. he hated the school. In schooling time, when he was a child, when he was going to the school, he doesn't like the schools. Second, according to him, school is congested. It means that he's not able to feeling free in the schools. According to him, school is like a prison, and he doesn't like prison. So he wanted to change the education system. He wanted to give education students in the natural environment and the open area. After his suffering in a school, he wanted to set up a school where the child could be free, creative. She was able to develop her thoughts and desire. It means that school is not a building in which students are going for the education. According to him, school is an open building, and it is in the natural environment where the students can interact with the environment and they develop creativity in their own. Now, we will discuss about the Tagore's idea of the education. It's the last page, and we will discuss in this page about the education policy that he wanted, that is wanted by the Tagore. Its first feature is, childhood is a time of self-learning. Child will be able to learn by himself. Means a not particular syllabus, a particular books didn't impose on the students. Children are able to get learn with the interaction of the natural environment. Second is, teachers had the power to understand the child's thinking, and teachers are able to create the imaginity in the students. Third, according to him, creative learning is important. It could be encouraged only in the natural environment. For this, he established a school away from Calcutta, near about 100 kilometers away, and it is known as the Shanti Niketan. It is established in the 1901. In it, children interact with the natural environment, and the children learn by themselves. Now, we will discuss about the difference between the Mahatma Gandhi and Tagore's views regarding the education. Both Mahatma Gandhi and Tagore both wanted the Indian education system, but the views they have differ. According to Mahatma Gandhi, he was highly critical of the Western education and also criticize the mechanization, means machinikaran. वो महात्मा गांधी चाहते थे कि मशीनीकरण है, मतलब इंडिया में नहीं आना चाहिए. अगर मशीनों से काम होना शुरू हो गया तो जो इंडियन लोग हैं वो लोग फ्री हो जाएंगे और उनको अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट फेस करनी पड़ेगी. हाँ जी, अकॉर्डिंग टू रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर, ही वॉन्टेड टू कंबाइन वेस्टर्न सिविलाइजेशन विद द इंडियन ट्रेडिशन. मतलब वो दोनों ही चाहते थे कि अगर मैकेनाइजेशन आना भी है तो वो भी आ सकता है, बट जो इंडियन कल्चर और इंडियन ट्रेडिशन है और वेस्टर्न सिविलाइजेशन है, मतलब बोथ विल डिवेलप बाय. सो अ लॉन्ग डिबेट्स वर ऑलवेज हेल्ड अबाउट द एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन इंडिया, एंड इट ऑल्सो हेल्ड इन द आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस और टिल इट इज कॉन्टिन्यूइंग अबाउट द एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन द इंडिया. सो इन दिस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द व्यूज ऑफ द एजुकेशन by Mahatma Gandhi and the Rabindranath Tagore, and we also discuss about the schooling system before the Britishers and after the entry of the Britishers.